What do you think is the most destructive tool in the world? Hey, I'm Alex Lam, and in this episode of Stories of the World, we're going to be talking about Adolf Hitler's telephone. The telephone was used for the last 2 years of World War II, which was considered the deadliest military conflict in history. By the end of World War II, it was estimated 70 to 85 million people died. Now, to put this into perspective, how much 70 million people is, that's higher than the populations of most countries. Imagine any of these countries' entire population disappearing. Adolf Hitler's telephone, without a doubt, is one of the most destructive tools in history. So let's talk about it. Now, at the end of World War II, a gentleman named Sir Ralph Rayner, then second command of Field Marshal Bernard Montgomery's communications in the 21st Army Group, was tasked to make contact with his Soviet counterpart. Traveling through Berlin, Sir Ralph arrived at which remained of the Reich Chancellery. He was greeted by a Soviet officer who, after notifying that his general would meet Sir Ralph, offered to show him the bunker that they had discovered a few days earlier. The Soviet officer showed him Hitler's private quarters and, eager to please Sir Ralph, offered the black telephone that sat beside Everett Brown's table. However, Ralph was more intrigued by the red telephone near Hitler's bed. So Ralph wittily said, red was his favorite color. So the Soviet officer presented that to him instead. While Sir Ralph was in possession of the telephone, Montgomery had decreed that anyone caught looting would be court-martialed. Key word, court. So let me know in the comments below. If you were Sir Ralph, would you have returned the telephone to the government or looted more? You know, live life on the edge. Like, you just want a war, goddammit. Like, what's a bit of looting gonna do? Personally, I would loot some more, you know. If I had to choose an item, I would definitely take Hitler's underwear. I don't know, I feel like just framing it and having it in your house, and like when your buddies come over, you know, they're coming in and they're like, hey, what's with the framed underwear? You can be like, oh yeah, that's Hitler's underwear, man. And then your friends would say, what's with the big shit stain? But back to the story. So when Sir Ralph arrived home to Devon, UK, he made sure no one outside the family knew about the telephone. The secret was kept from 1935 till 1955. And in 1955, he finally felt like enough time has passed that he could show it off to the public. Now, once the secret was out, the family had spoken of the telephone regularly. When Sir Ralph passed away, the picture so chosen for his obituary in the local newspaper in 1977 was one of Sir Ralph and the Hitler telephone. Rayner's son inherited the telephone and sold it via auction for $243,000 USD to an unnamed buyer in 2017. Now, I think it's a little sad that Rayner's son sold the telephone. It would have been a lot better, I think, if he just loaned it to a museum and kept it as a family heirloom. And plus, the museum has, you know, they have all the tools to sort of protect it, you know, behind the glass cases and whatnot, but, you know, it is what it is. But now it's in someone's private collection, you know, for the public, we don't know where it is, right? Maybe the auction house would know, but yeah, it kind of sucks. But I know what a lot of you guys are thinking. There are so many unanswered questions. Like, how did Hitler respond to prank calls? Did Hitler prank call anybody? How did their family keep the secret for 20 years? So that's the story of Adolf Hitler's telephone. If you guys enjoyed the video, hit the like button and subscribe if you want to hear more stories. I'm Alex Lam, and this is Stories of the World.